Welcome to the OpenMWCS video of this release. The editor's development status and speed are still lagging behind our engine. However, this release brings some long-awaited features. Curious? Let's have a look at what's new. Our script editor has seen some improvements since the last release. You are now able to comment and uncomment code by using the context menu or the corresponding shortcuts. Please note that you need to define the latter in the user preferences first. Moreover, clicking on a variable now marks all occurrences of that variable in a script. This feature vastly improves coding, especially in the case of long and complex scripts. If you don't like the highlighting color, or if you want to completely disable this feature, just head over to your user preferences and change the corresponding settings. Speaking of the user preferences, OpenMWCS veterans will notice that the irritating scroll bar on the left pane of the preferences window is now gone. Strangely satisfying. We have also added the option to reset all settings or the settings of a category respectively. Category refers to the tabs in the left pane, so using the option in the key bindings tab will reset all subtabs. In previous versions of our editor, the map color field in the cells table did not display a color picker, but rather a spin box to enter integer values. This issue has been fixed in the current release. Additionally, our color picker widget now includes a fully functional text field showing the current color's hexadecimal equivalent. I promised you long-awaited features, and you shall get them. OpenMWCS finally includes land and land texture records. These were the last missing record types from the vanilla engine's file format. Please note that implementing them was a quite difficult task, and that working with these record types may still lead to unexpected results. So, what are these record types? Basically, every cell has a corresponding land record which holds landscape information about that cell. This includes the cell's coordinates, the cell height offset, the actual terrain elevation, and associated land textures. In OpenMWCS, you are only able to add, clone, delete, revert, or touch a land record. Touch means that the record will be marked as modified, while no changes are made to the record data itself. Land texture records provide information about the terrain textures used in a cell. They map texture files with unique IDs. You can change terrain textures using these records, but be aware that land texture records are only used in cells whose land records have been modified. Modders should prefer to use the standard practice of overriding textures instead, as this will ensure greater compatibility with other mods. Last but not least, version 0.43 includes a post 1.0 feature which got implemented a bit earlier. The ability to reload resource files on the fly. If you press F5, OpenMWCS will check all data directories and refresh its internal list of resources. Then, all preview windows and scene views will be updated with the new files. You've just realized how bad these banners look. Simply grab Lysol's GUA Skin Banner's normal map for OpenMW, add the texture files to your local OpenMW directory, and hit F5. Ah, nice. Do you have a feeling that Vivek looks a bit dull? Well, simply grab Lysol's Vivek normal map for OpenMW, add the texture files to your local OpenMW directory, and, surprise, hit F5. Well, if you get the impression that I like Lysol's mods, you're damn right. But I also like this little feature of reloading assets without having to close OpenMWCS each time you want to change something. That's it. Nothing more to say about this release. Hopefully, we can tackle the remaining complex tasks for OpenMWCS in the not-too-distant future. If you're skilled in Qt or C++, please consider helping us out on the editor's side. Remember, a fully functional construction set is one of OpenMW's main goals for version 1.0. Anyway, also consider reading through the official release notes for more in-depth information and visit our forums on openmw.org. Until next time, thanks for watching.